So hey everyone, I'm Kashish. I lead product management for Amazon Inspector, which is our vulnerability management solution, and also Amazon Macy, which is our sensitive data discovery solution at AWS. So today in this session, we'll talk about Lambda service or Lambda functions or serverless functions in general, and how Inspector can help you cover security specifically around the code, the application that you deploy on Lambda service from a security perspective, from an application security perspective specifically. So this would be our agenda. What is Amazon Inspector? What problems we are trying to solve? What Lambda scanning does with Inspector? And then we can do a quick demo if time permits. And towards the end, we can also do Q&A if you have any more questions. So to start with, first, what serverless is and what the shared responsibility model is between AWS and the customer, as such as yourselves. So if you look at the portion at the bottom, which is everything from hardware to a lot of the operating system and also compute, is something that AWS manages. And the security of that is managed by AWS, so you don't have to patch the servers. And as most of you might be aware, Lambda functions can run up to 15 minutes at once to perform a specific action. So all of those is covered by AWS. But the application that you deploy to Lambda service in form of functions through zips or even container images now, a lot of that is your responsibility. So for example, the application code that you write can still be exploited once it is deployed. And I'll get into the example and the specifics, how it can be done and what we are seeing in the market, in the industry in general. Also, identity and access management around Lambda functions. So what permissions do Lambda functions have, like elevated privileges of what it can do and things like that, is again your responsibility. And finally, the configuration of Lambda functions. Security Hub does provide a lot of those things already in form of controls and standards that we provide around configuration. So all of these things are still your responsibility. And in this session, specifically we are talking about Amazon Inspector, which is our vulnerability management and application security solution. We will cover the first part, which is customer function code and libraries. So before we get into the details, I do want to give you a quick background on what Amazon Inspector is. If you Google Amazon Inspector, you might find two Amazon Inspectors. One is Inspector Classic, and there is one new Amazon Inspector. Inspector Classic was launched about 7 or 8 years ago. It is still in the market. We do plan to deprecate it, but it was built like a long time ago, and cloud has evolved a lot since then. And the ephemeral nature of cloud and in general, like the velocity at which customers deploy their workloads have changed tremendously. So about a year and a half ago at reInvent 2021, we relaunched Amazon Inspector. This is the new version. It works completely differently. There is no overlap even in the backend components. We built it from scratch to adapt to cloud, and we had a few philosophies, like we had to make it really simple for customers to use. We know all security teams are short-staffed, so we wanted to make sure it is really easy for operators to manage it and consume findings really easily. With the new Inspector that we launched about a year and a half ago, we do support EC2 instances, container images, which are residing in ECR, which is Elastic Container Registry, and also Lambda functions. So in this specific session, we'll talk about Lambda functions and what all we offer. This is something we just covered. Like, we also provide coverage details, and I'll show in the demo how everything looks like so that you know if Inspector is not managing or scanning any of your resources, you have that visibility, so there's no coverage gaps in the in your kind of scanning coverage. There are also, so one of the primary things that Amazon Inspector does is, or the new one, is we identify vulnerabilities in near real time. So after you, it's a one-click enablement. So once you enable Inspector for Lambda functions and container images, you don't need any agent, you don't need to configure anything. As soon as you enable, we will start detecting all the functions that you deploy to Lambda service within seconds. And if anything changes in your function, for example, you update a function, or a new CV is published that impacts a specific function, we immediately detect that. Everything is event-driven. We immediately detect that, and we start generating findings without any manual action. So the idea is that, let's say, if your developers deployed a function, let's say, 1 month ago, and something like Log4j was announced yesterday. Now, even if you're not updating your function, there could be new risk that is added to it. So we provide those details in real time so that you don't have to worry about, you know, detecting your vulnerabilities across your estate. Then there are other things that we have. Since everything is event-driven, we do provide multiple ways for you to get the results, including EventBridge, which was formerly known as CloudWatch Events. So any new finding, when it is generated, or a finding is closed, we also maintain the state of the finding. If you patch something or you know, update a package in your Lambda function, we would close that finding. So if anything changes in your environment, from new function getting deployed to new finding getting generated to finding any closed, we push all those events to EventBridge. And that helps customers essentially automate their ticketing system. So I've worked with several customers that have integrated with Jira and ServiceNow. So if a new finding is created based on the tags, it gets routed to the appropriate developer. And once you close it, it would again generate event that this finding has been closed. It would go and close the Jira ticket. So it avoids all the manual effort you need, you have to put in to manage just the ticketing system. So let's talk about support for Lambda functions. We offer two types of scanning for Lambda functions. One is standard scanning, one is code scanning. Standard scanning has been in the market since November 2022, so about 6 months now. And Lambda code scanning was in public preview for the last 3 months. We just announced general availability of it yesterday. So to give you an example, I'll talk about an example and explain to you what's the difference. So let's say you write an application, a calculator application. Now, as a part of the calculator application, the user experience is if a user goes in and types 1 plus 1, a Lambda function would get spin up. It would does the calculation, performs the business logic, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. It returns the result to the user and it kind of shuts down. That's how Lambda function would work, right? So let's say if you are writing that function in Python. So as a part of that, you would have to consume some dependencies like math.py or any functions like dependency libraries that you have to import as a part of that function. So what standard scanning would do is, standard scanning will identify CVEs or software vulnerabilities in all the dependency that you consume. And we have seen a lot of increased activity where hackers or malicious actors are putting malicious and vulnerable libraries, packages in repositories like PyPy, which is public repository for Python. And if developers don't know what's the right or wrong dependency, they would just go to PyPy and download it, right? And if you download a malicious dependency as a part of your function, or a vulnerable dependency, that could lead to exploitation. So what could happen is, once a Lambda function is invoked, it would perform that action, going back to my example. It would still do 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. But in addition, it could do a lot of the other things like exfiltrating secrets or deleting an S3 bucket or whatever the hacker wants it to do. So a lot of the things can be done. And there were some packages like Phylum, which were being used to exfiltrate secrets, and there was never a CVE published for it, but Inspector was able to identify those also because of the threat hunting that we do, vulnerability intelligence sources that we consume. Even though CVE wasn't assigned, we were able to identify such things also. So that's standard scanning. Now with code scanning that we launched yesterday, with code scanning, we also look at the code that you write. So in addition to the package that you consume, the business logic that you write, where 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, if you're using weak cryptographic functions, or if you have embedded secrets, or if you have any OWASP top 10 issues like injection flaws, cross-site scripting flaws, we also identify that in real time now. One thing I do want to call out is that in addition to functions, if you are consuming Lambda layers in a function, we identify vulnerabilities in those also, and we do tag them. So if a vulnerability is identified in the function, we will tag that it's the main function. If it's in a layer, we identify that in the layer also. So these are some of the screenshots in terms of activation. It's one-click enablement. If you want to enable only standard scanning, you can do that. If you want both Lambda standard and code scanning, you can do that also. Inspector does have like its central delegated admin, which is essentially integration with AWS organizations. If you do assign a delegated admin account, which will act as a central account, you can activate standard or both scanning for all your environment literally with one click. This is one of the examples of what a standard scanning result would look like. So we do give you multiple things, details like what's the basic description of that CVE, what's the severity, if a fix is available or not, like what is the installed version, for example, URL lib 3 was used and epoch was 2, 1.24.3 version, and where it is fixed in, so that what developers should update it to. We also provide you things like exploit available. So if an exploit is available, which means it's like hackers have exploited that in the wild, we get a lot of the vulnerability intelligence, and we also provide you things like when it was last exploited at in the wild, not in your environment, but in the wild. So we give all those information, and as of late last week, we also provide EPSS score in addition to CVSS score. EPSS score is exploit predictability scoring system, which is developed by the same force.org, which provides CVSS score, but it adds additional context because it helps you with actual exploitation. It will give you exact results on, or somewhat a rough estimate of like probability of that getting exploited based on what they have seen. So we do provide that score also in addition to CVSS score and what we call inspector score, which is highly contextualized. Now, this is our code scanning finding. So in code scanning finding, again, we do give you basic details on what it is. And the main part is the vulnerability location. We will tell you exact line we have found that vulnerability in, what is the vulnerability, and we also provide you suggested remediation. What we are doing right now is we also provide for a lot of the findings actual code that your developers need to replace it with, so that they don't have to worry about how to fix that vulnerability. We will give you that actual code snippet that you can copy and paste into the code. Very soon, by end of this year, we will also introduce generative AI to generate that code. So that, let's say, if there are hard-coded secrets and you want to use AWS Secret Manager or HashiCorp, we will give you multiple options. If you're using HashiCorp Vault, just copy-paste this exact code and copy to your code. Or if you're using Secrets Manager, just copy that code. So let me show you a quick demo on how everything looks like in Inspector really quick. So this is how Inspector dashboard looks like. We do offer 15-day free trial, by the way, for all accounts and each type of scanning. And this is the dashboard where you can see your holistic view. This is my delegated admin account. So I can see how many accounts are activated with Inspector, what all instances are being covered by Inspector, in specifically EC2 instances. If something is not being managed by Inspector, we do give you why not, so that you have actionable guidance. So for example, this instance is not managed by SSM agent, so we give you actionable guidance. This is what you need to do. Similarly, for Lambda functions, we give you what all is being scanned or actively monitored by Inspector, and what all is not being actively monitored for both code scanning and standard scanning separately. So here you get all those details, and then I already showed you the findings. one of the things that we launched yesterday was also export of SBOMs, or Software Bill of Materials. this is free of cost, and SBOM you can export for any inspector monitored resource. So including Lambda functions, so any packages or even transitive dependencies that might be added as a part of your jar files or Python packages, we do identify that. And we do export it in both Cyclone DX and SPDX formats. And then you can run Athena queries on it. I can, if there is time afterwards, I know we are short on time, I can show you how you can run the Athena queries on it. And you can also identify things like, you know, which package and which version is being used across your entire environment, not just Lambda functions. You can group it by resources also, but the idea is that you can see across your environment which package is being used the most, even if it doesn't have a vulnerability right now. So like Log4j, before a CVE was announced, if you know where all it is, you will know how important your software or what packages are, and you can map your whole software supply chain and, you know, generate trends in QuickSight and things like that. One other thing I do want to call out is we also launched this feature about, I guess, a month ago, where we do expose our vulnerability intelligence database. So to show you an example, even if a CVE is not identified in your environment, you can search Inspector on what all details are out there. So this one is for Log4j. We give you the basic details, what platforms are affected by it, because each CVE impacts Amazon Linux versus Red Hat versus others differently. We do give you EPS score. So 0.97 is like 97%, which is extremely high. And other things like, how does it map to MITRE TNT framework? Like which technique, which sub-techniques does it map to? Which industries were targeted by this kind of CVE? When was the last known public exploit? We also give you more information around CISA, when it was added to CISA or when the fix was reported to CISA and things like that. Very soon in our findings, we will also add additional vulnerability intelligence, like which malware kits are being used to exploit a CVE, or how social media trends are being kind of, you know, projected. For example, when Log4j was announced, there was so much traffic on Twitter talking about that. So all those things, we want to empower all your security analysts and developers to get enough information within Inspector to go and fix those vulnerabilities. And like I was saying, you can see by Lambda function, and there are multiple ways you can see the findings. And anytime a new finding is generated, you can sort by age. So even if I'm standing here, you might be able to see, you know, some findings were generated 9 hours ago or 17 hours ago. It just automatically comes in. From a user standpoint, it's really easy. You don't really have to do anything except for click on activate. I know we are at the top of the hour, so I can take questions like on the side if you have any questions. But feel free to try it out. We do give a 15-day free trial. And it is extremely cheap. Like, if you compare it with any other vendor in the market, it'll be, like, a very cheap. We have tried to make it really cheap because we believe security should be very standard, not something we capitalize on. All right. Thanks, everyone.